Hey guys, so today I'm going to be filming a what I eat in a day video, and I always start my day off with some water. I keep it by my bedside and I take a couple sips, and then once I'm up I first take my vitamins. So in addition to drinking my regular bottle of water, I just take a few sips of that in the morning, and then I always have lemon water. I try to do like room temperature water, and after this I have my green smoothie. And then throughout the day I'll continue to fill up my water bottle and drink a couple of these. And that's it. That's it for now anyway. Make my green smoothies just a little bit different every time. It just depends what I have in the fridge, what I have a taste for. Sometimes I want like a really green smoothie, and sometimes I'm like, I'm not really want too many greens today, so I'll just use like a little bit of spinach or just a handful. This one's a pretty good mix. I can taste a lot of the green. It's I used about 2 kale leaves. Well, it was really 4, but they were small, so I used 4. And then 2 bunches of spinach and 1 pear, a little bit of coconut water, which is sweet, but you gotta be careful with that, because if you add too much coconut water, it'll be way too sweet. And for me, I'm not like a sweet tooth kind of person. So anyway, always use what you have, and I'm definitely gonna share this recipe and post it on my blog. I'll have the link down there, and actually I'll probably just write it in the description box too. So anyway, this is one of my new favorite combinations to make my green smoothie. No matter how hard I try. Alright, now that I'm completely awake and don't look completely sleepy, I'm gonna talk about the snack I just had. That was my all-time favorite apple almond butter combination. Added a banana in there. But I find that when I add the almond butter, it keeps me full a little bit longer. I probably had that snack about a little more than two hours after I had that green smoothies. I don't know what I'm gonna have for lunch yet, but I'm kind of thinking I'm gonna have some leftovers. But just stay tuned, and we'll be in the kitchen again in a second. Contrast, kill a pro. That was probably the laziest salad you've ever seen in your life, but I'm totally proud of it. I'm all about like fast food, and for me, fast food is throwing ingredients in a bowl and just like chowing down or grabbing a piece of fruit and running out the door. I did have some leftover cooked lentils from before, so I added those just right in my salad again to try not to let anything go to waste. And then the white powdery substance that you saw, that was actually non-cashew Parmesan cheese. And it's vegan, of course. I'm definitely going to share that recipe very soon if I haven't already. I'm not sure which I'm going to post yet. Why Parmesan cheese on my salad? Because cheese, right? I mean, it's really good, and it just adds another element of flavor. This soup is a split pea soup, which if you follow me on Instagram, you had seen me make it in my Instagram story. I don't think I have a post, like an official post on it on my page, but I'm not sure if I'm gonna share this recipe yet. I will link it down below just so that you can like see the ingredients that I use, but it was like throw everything in a pot and put a lid on it, walk away, set a timer, and then it was done. The red powder that I put on top is actually smoked paprika. The smoked paprika on top definitely rounds this soup right on out. So anyway, I'm gonna enjoy some lunch and I'll see you back at dinner time. Afternoon. A little bit late for what I'm about to have, but I'm definitely going to share with you. It's coffee. So I do still drink coffee. Coffee is like become a snack in the afternoon. So in the morning I usually have fruit for a snack, as you saw, and in the afternoon after I have lunch I kind of have it like dessert in the afternoon. So I'm going to show you how I make my coffee now. Okay, so I have everything here in front of me. Not sure if you can see it, but I'm gonna bring it up a little bit closer to the camera. So the first thing I need is coffee. Boom. Okay, here's my 1 cup measurement, and here's my blender cup, and I'll get to this detail in a second. So I'm going to measure out 1 cup of coffee, which is just about right what's in the pot. This is my favorite coconut milk to use. It's from Whole Foods. It's a 365 brand. And I store it in this little jar here. It has a little seal and it locks and it keeps it pretty fresh. You could also use a mason jar and it'll do the same thing. So I'm gonna just measure out in my cup 2 tablespoons. Also, this is full fat coconut milk. You could use light, but you might need a little bit more. I lied. I'm gonna use 3. 3 tablespoons, sorry guys. So 3 tablespoons. And this is what it looks like right now. You're probably like, ew, I need my coffee like super creamy lip, like that doesn't look creamy at all. I gotcha, give me a second. So the next thing that we're gonna do, I have Stevia. This is the New Naturals brand. It's pretty low. We've been through a lot together. And I actually prefer it now in my coffee than anything else. So I'm not sure how to measure this, unfortunately. I mean, I would, but this is just how I do it. I'm gonna show you. It's just a real quick, like, boom. That's it. And that was like, if I had to guess, an 1/8 or a 1/4 of a teaspoon. At this point, I mean, I could get a spoon and I could mix it around on a lazier day. I would do that, but since I had a lazy salad, I have a little bit of energy in me. So we're just gonna blend this up, and it's like a magic trick. So like now it's this like dark brown color, and the color's gonna change. Boom. It's like Houdini was right in this blender. No. So now that's all blended up, I'm gonna pour it in my mug, or actually I don't even need to pour it in my mug. I can just untwist. This is the Nutribullet, by the way. I can just untwist, and because I used the one with the handle, just drink it right out of here. So, cafe au lait or that was whack, I'm sorry. So yeah, this is the coffee I'm gonna have, and I'll pretty much sip on it until it's cold, and I like to savor every sip because I love coffee. I crave it. I want it. I don't need it per se, but again, we'll talk about the needs and not needs and the addiction and all that with coffee in another post. But for right now, I'm gonna enjoy my mug-ish of coffee, and I'll see you guys at dinner time. Hello guys, good evening. It's dinner time, and for dinner I'm going to have something very simple. Again, it's going to be a salad and rice, and I'll talk about the rice in just a second. For now, for the salad, it's going to be a kale salad, and I'm going to show you how I make one of the, like, one of my most favorite, very simple, no blender, just a bowl and a spoon, and we're going to make a dressing. So let me show you real quick. Okay, so it might look like a lot of ingredients, but really some of them are optional. You combine those in a bowl with just like a splash of water, you're gonna get this amazing creamy dressing in like 10 seconds. So now at this point, all my ingredients are in the bowl, and I'm going to just drizzle this on top. Just gonna use it all. I will write the recipe down below. Now, we're going to not use a spoon. I mean, you could use a spoon if you want to be all neat and not get your hands dirty, but I am a firm believer that using your hands, there's flavor in there. So, that's what we're going to do. Boom. I'm going to give it a little bit of a somewhat of a massage, if that makes sense, but you'll see. Just kind of mix it in as you go. You're kind of adding the dressing in between like all those leaves. You're probably thinking like, that's a small salad, but honestly, the fiber and the protein in this is gonna like fill me up on top of the second part of my dinner that I'm gonna show you in just a moment. So yeah, so this looks friggin' amazing if you ask me. So bang, we're all done. Check that out with my dirty hands. How does that look? Hopefully it looks amazing. I think it looks great. Anyway, simple favorite to go to salad. Okay, so with the rest of my dinner in tow, I have my rice. So this is Puerto Rican rice. So this is my version of ajo con gandules. By the time I share this video, I know that this recipe won't be up. I am currently working on like the perfect way to do it. Now again, that's actually up for debate too, because some people like less salt, some people like more salt. I'm kind of like in the middle, and I feel like this version, it came out really good. I felt like I need to tweak it a little bit, if that makes sense. So once I get this version down, I definitely will share it, I promise you. For now, I'm going to link down below my white rice and my stewed beans, or habichuelas quesada, and that's going to be down there. Anyway, this is what I'm going to have for dinner. My rice and beans, or my rice and pigeon peas, and my salad and my tahini dressing. So, I'm gonna share all of my goodies for today, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Next time, I plan on like having more cooking involved. I feel like today I ate really light, really simple. honestly didn't have too much of an appetite, and I was gonna make something for dinner, but I had this rice and I'm like, I'm just gonna eat these leftovers. So I'm a firm believer in not wasting food, so I just wanted to keep this 100% honest, and this is dinner tonight. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to see more like this, give this video a thumbs up. Let me know. Comment down below. If you aren't already subscribed, please subscribe to my channel. And yeah, so I'll see you next time. Thanks so much for tuning in. Have a nice night or a good day or good afternoon. And I'll see you then. Bye. I think I said I was working on perfecting this recipe. This is really good. Honestly made this a few days ago and I felt like it got better with time. But like when I initially had it, I was like, this is missing something. But like right now, this is really good. I don't know. I guess I have to make a video now, huh?